here's the railroad tracks.
Okay.
I'm gonna turn 290. There we go, avoiding the city.
Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back to Heavy Metal Horizons. So I don't know how many of you saw my Aeronca Chief video. That was the video where I announced that I had purchased a 1946 Aeronca Chief. But in that video, I was talking about how one of my plans was to fly that airplane from Van Nuys, California, up to the Seattle, Washington area, basically doing this long flight up and back down the West Coast. Now, the only problem is I have done almost no flying, like general aviation flying, in Washington State. The only thing I've done was a seaplane discovery flight, which I actually have a video for here on the channel. But everything else is new to me. So if you can't tell already by all the trees behind me, I am in Washington State right now. So what I've done is I have scheduled a flight with a CFI, this guy Justin Echo, which I've never met him before, but I think it's gonna turn out good. And he's with Snohomish Flying Service. So he's going to give me basically a local area familiarization flight. Show me around the area, I'll be able to do some flying with him, kind of learn the ropes of the area and the geography. So the big thing is this is some preparation for when I make that long flight, because I'm gonna fly from California up here, and then I'm gonna stay maybe for a week or at least a few days and then fly around the area and everything. But other than the preparation, the other thing is that I have just always heard that Washington State is one of the most beautiful places for flying, for private airplane, general aviation flying. There's a channel here on YouTube called Backcountry 182, and according to him, Washington State is one of the best places to fly in the world in terms of the variety and different places you can land, and you know, the water and the mountains and the trees and backcountry and large airports, everything mixed together. He says it's one of the best places in the world. Somebody there right now? So naturally, I wanted to share this with you guys, so I've brought some GoPros with me, and hopefully you're gonna see in this video a little taste of just how good Washington flying can be. So guys, as always, if you enjoy this stuff, airplanes, cars, and ham radio, if you enjoy any of that, and you have not already subscribed to the channel, please consider subscribing right now. Okay, let's go ahead and head up to Harvey Field in Snohomish, Washington, and see what it's like.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 9470 Foxtrot, departing 33 right northbound, Harvey.
Harvey traffic, Fox 1910 Foxtrot, leftbound with runway 33 right, Harvey.
Alright, they cleared the runway, good.
Okay.
Alright, wind close, 2000, indication's good.
Alright.
Full power, let's go. All right, airspeed's alive, 50 knots. All right.
Look at her go.
There she goes.
Caravan 4, or Harvey traffic, Caravan 4, departing 33 right, climbing north.
Harvey traffic, Dutchess 50 November, left downwind 33 right.
All
right,
here's the railroad tracks.
Okay.
I'm gonna turn 290. There we go, avoiding the city.
Yeah, I gotta say, this view beats California, man. All the airports are out in the desert usually.
Yeah, we got the scenery here.
Harvey, traffic shot 4901, Foxtrot, turning monorally 33 right, Harvey.
And don't forget to zoom out before we depart.
Yeah. We got another crosswind in sight. Are you guys going to the north?
Says your Foxtrot is going northbound, Harvey.
Copy that. I got you in sight. I'm going to pass off to your left, Harvey.
Thank you.
All right, so here, we're headed towards Skagit. Just be aware of the
following the traffic. It's a Cessna 53.
The Whitney Charlie airspace is right there.
Right. Okay.
It's always nice to just follow along I-5.
IFR, right? I fly road.
Yeah.
The other thing I like about this, at least down here in the valley, plenty of open fields to make an emergency landing in if you needed to.
Oh yeah.
Can I take controls?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, cool.
You have the controls.
I have the controls.
You have the controls.
Traffic,
thank you.
I was like, coming up on the shoreline, straight in runway 11. Gotcha.
Yeah, the airport's kind of hard to see, but it's like around those groupings of trees, a little past that.
Okay.
Yeah. We'll see it as we get closer.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't see anything. What is that? Is that some kind of steam or something that's coming up there?
Yeah, it's the city of Anacortes.
Okay. I guess if it's going all the time, it's probably a good landmark.
Yeah.
Oh, I see it now.
Oh, like there
it's
we are.
Between the trees, right?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Okay, so left pattern 1-1.
Left pattern 1-1.
Okay, I'll go a little wider there.
Yeah. Dumb on it.
Sketchy traffic, Cessna 947, Sierra Foxtrot, 5 miles southeast will be following traffic on entry of 45, left downwind, runway 11, touch and go, Skagit.
And traffic pattern, altitude is?
1200. Okay.
Traffic,
do a slow descent.
Charlie will position and hold on runway 11.
Rich, mixture rich by this point probably.
I think, I'll do the downwind kind of on the outside of these trees. You think that seems about a good distance?
Yeah.
Okay.
No, that's good.
Sketch traffic, Cessna 947, Sierra Foxtrot, left downwind, runway 11, number 2, touch and go, sketch it.
I always like follow, is the runway about halfway up the strut? That's pretty good.
Charlie, we see somebody coming in on the 45, we're going to go behind you. And then head westbound. Skagit.
Looking out for you, 7-0 Foxtrot.
Yeah, with the trees there, it's hard to see.
Yeah.
Okay, and we'll go flaps 10.
Skagit 374, Mike Alpha, clear the
stay below 85.
Yeah.
Perfect. Excellent. And we usually pull throttle about 1500.
Okay.
Traffic, Cirrus 5 Mike X-ray, order 6 miles southeast, now planning left downwind entry for 11, full stop, Skagit.
Skagit area traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, turning left base, 11, touch and go, Skagit.
There's the runway, cool stuff.
Okay, and we'll go to 20.
Below 85, yep, no. Keep it perfect. Briefed it. I think this sign has a glide path. The other one does.
Skagit traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, turning final, 11, touch go, Skagit.
Alright, there you go. Glide path. Alright, yeah, about 60. Line through the runway.
Get over the fence.
A little bit more to the right for center line for me.
Okay.
But it's also a ride, wide. So. Yep, he's on the round out. Get up, yep.
I'll be
bleed
there.
It off, bleed it off.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
All right. Laps up, full power.
Downwind for 11,
full power.
Dispatcher traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, departing to the south. Gadget.
Alright, you want to go back up to 2000?
Yeah, 2000, okay. 2500, that's fine. Okay. Get back home.
The thing that really impresses me about Washington is, as far as aviation goes, right, you have so many different things you can do, but it's all close together. Like, you know, if you want to be an airline pilot, I mean, you've got SeaTac and you've got big airports or Portland, but then you've got guys who are like bush flying or whatever, you know, and it's just like, you know, probably half an hour or an hour away.
Oh, yeah. Crazy.
And then all the seaplane stuff, I mean.
So much to do.
Yeah. There's somebody that lives out in the Midwest or something, you don't really have all the choices out there.
Right. Yeah. See that cumulus development. Wow.
Yeah. Like, stay over there.
Yeah.
With the weather like this time of year, do you have that kind of typical thing where the mornings are pretty bad and then it burns off?
Foggy, June gloom. June gloom action.
Yeah. Okay.
So just be cognizant. So Everett's over here. If you stay over the valley, it's fine. But then you've got the pain. Delta airspace.
Right. Okay.
So just watch out for that. Listening to what they're doing at Harvey.
Okay.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot. 6 miles northwest, we'll be entering a 45 downwind, 33 right, Harvey.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 34, let's go back to take off, runway 33. Harvey traffic.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, over the river bend, we'll be entering a 45 downwind, 33 right, Harvey.
Harvey traffic,
Cessna 6767.
Turning left downwind, 33 right, we're
going to
be departing the downwind, southbound, Harvey.
And it's behind the trees, the white hangars right there.
Yeah, I can see the hangars, but not the runway, right? It's just behind those.
Right.
Harvey traffic, Skyline 8753 Victor, through the northwest, at the river bend, maneuver for the 45433, number 2, Harvey.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, established on the 45, left downwind, 33 right, Harvey.
Yeah, we'll stick to 20 degrees of flaps in this case.
Sure.
And we have a normal pattern somewhat. There we go.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 8753 Victor is on the 45 for 33 number 2, Harvey.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, left downwind, 33 right, Harvey.
Five, flaps 10 degrees.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, turning left base, 33 right, Harvey.
Harvey traffic, Skyline 8753 Victor, left downwind, midfield, 33 right, Harvey.
Keep coming.
Yeah, I see what you're saying about these trees.
Harvey traffic, 767, 3 miles to the south of Harvey, departing to the south, final call, Harvey.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 947 Sierra Foxtrot, turning, final, 33 right, Harvey.
Not so bad, just don't overshoot. The 30 degrees of bank, all right, like what I see. Maintaining our sight picture. RP on, of course.
Harvey traffic, Cessna 9752 Victor, left base, 50 right, number 2, Harvey.
center line. On 60 knots. Fast. Nine.
Alright, Johnny, Cessna 947, Sierra Foxtrot, clear runway, Harvey.
Woo! Yeah. Awesome. Well, dude, that was just what I was hoping for, man.
Yeah.
That was great.
Awesome, man.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, of course. Anytime.
Okay, guys. So that was a ton of fun. That was exactly what I was hoping for. You know, Justin was really cool. He just showed me, you know, just the general area. You know, he's warning me about conflictions with other nearby airspace. The airspace around here is very busy. Like, there's a lot of different types of airspace in a really close area. And the stuff that I'm going to be interested in is going to be like, you know, non-towered class golf type airports and everything. And there's a lot of that around here, but then you also have the Bravo with SeaTac and all of Seattle and that kind of stuff. So really cool airspace. The big thing about it that really impressed me the most is just how beautiful it is. I mean, there's rivers, lakes, the ocean, mountains, trees, all kinds of cloud formations, and it's all right in a little area. Check this out. There's somebody landing right now. Okay, the other thing that was really cool about this is the airport itself, Harvey Field here in Snohomish, is a really, really cool airport. They have a restaurant, which I've been to before, like the Buzz Inn Steakhouse. But then they have, you know, they've got a flight school, they've got maintenance, they've got fuel, a lot of hangars. It's really well maintained. They have a grass runway as well as the paved runway. And then also there's some really interesting things about noise abatement procedures. So right when you take off, if you're heading north, you gotta hang a left right away to avoid flying over the town. And you're also, there's rising terrain there, so of course you want to turn left over the river, which is really cool. So yeah, guys, this was awesome. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly did. Let me know any questions and comments and stuff you have down below, and I will see you soon. If you enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll talk to you soon.